Now, with the only tri-state forecast that's independently certified most accurate, here's Chief Meteorologist Kevin Robinson.
Well, you had to be up early to see it, but that's right. Check out this WeatherBug time lapse. That on the right-hand side of your screen is actually a little bit in the way of sunshine from earlier today, but it has been a steady downhill progress throughout the afternoon. We clouded up pretty quickly this afternoon, and then we had a couple of rounds or bursts of snow across the area, and that deposited for most of us about a quarter to a half an inch of snow, but that was enough to create some serious travel problems. And really, again, the challenge for road crews will be timing these bursts of snow as they move across the area, because they'll be locally heavy, but they won't last that long. Now, here's Power 5 Live radar tonight. It's quiet out there right now, and a matter of fact, I suspect we are going to stay quiet for the better part, if not almost all night long, across the area. Temperatures have actually climbed too. Our winds have remained out of the south. They're out of the south ahead of an Arctic cold front. You see this switch in the arrows here across parts of Illinois? This is the leading edge of what's going to be some really bitterly cold air that will be in here tomorrow and then into tomorrow night as well. So look at our temperature trend. Through the evening, our temperatures have actually been climbing and have now flirted with the freezing mark. We're up to 31 degrees here in Cincinnati. That's the warmest it's been all afternoon. Here's a look at the overall weather pattern. We've got an area of low pressure up across the Great Lakes, but like spokes on a tire here, you see little waves of low pressure rotating with within this broader circulation. A matter of fact, you had one come through this afternoon. That's what brought the early afternoon snow. But then if you look back towards Peoria, you can almost see another spin here, and this is the round that will likely come in towards sunrise tomorrow. Now, right now, it looks like this next round of snow will be another quick burst, but the problem is, along with the next round of snow, look at the falling temperatures. Remember, I told you the leading edge of Arctic air, 23 in Peoria, 10 in Des Moines, compared to our near freezing temperatures here. So we're doing pretty good. And we'll stay relatively comfortable most of the night before those temperatures nosedive towards morning. By morning, we'll drop to about 23. That will actually be as you walk out the door, heading out the door to school and work. But look at Indianapolis at 9. So you get an idea where our air will be coming from tomorrow. This high of 29, that's at midnight. We won't be this warm tomorrow afternoon. And a matter of fact, with gusty north winds during the day, wind chills tomorrow will likely be in the teens and single digits. So it will be a bitterly cold ride home, a little bit different than your ride in. Here's a look at futurecast. Again, temperatures warmed up enough this evening for some of that to go over to a few sprinkles. Here we are at 7 o'clock. I want you to know how this next round of snow kind of builds into the area. Again, it won't last terribly long, won't be terribly heavy, but it's enough to put down about another quarter to half an inch, and that will make for slick roads. And then as we head into our Saturday, it looks like we'll start Saturday dry, but we'll probably cloud up quickly Saturday afternoon for what will be another quick hitting 1 to 2 inches of snow across the area, and this will likely make travel tricky for Saturday night. So the problem is, we're not dealing with one big heavy snowstorm. We're dealing with several weaker systems kind of putting down a couple of bouts of snow across the area. So 23 for a low tonight. Well, a few more snow showers and snow kicking up again by morning. Snow likely during the day tomorrow will be blustery and cold. Remember, 29, that's at midnight. It will feel like it's closer to probably 9 or 10 throughout the day tomorrow as temperatures will slip through the 20s. Notice by 5 o'clock, we'll be down into the teens. There should be a pretty stiff northwesterly wind as well. Here's your 7-day forecast. Talk about bitterly cold. Tomorrow night, we're dropping down to a low of 11. I suspect our wind chills tomorrow night will drop to around zero, maybe even a few degrees below. And then there's your snow Saturday. Sunday, Monday look like dry days. But if you thought winter was over, well, you got another thing coming. We've got a lot more colder air coming as we head into the middle of next week.